Hi, I'm Kristi Gustafson with the Times Union and timesunion.com, and I'm joined today by Paulina Bucka. You may recognize Paulina from her time earlier this year at WNYT. She was an anchor and reporter there, and she left earlier in the summer. So she's going to talk to us today a little bit about why she left, what's next, and more. Hi, Paulina. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, Kristi. Thank you for having me. I'm so excited to be here.
I'm excited to have you too. So you came in to work as a morning anchor. You moved here from Kentucky. You sort of uprooted your whole life. You were here for a few months and then you decided to leave the station in July. So talk to us a little bit about why you left and then what's next.
So when I left, Kristi, Kentucky, I should say, finished my contract. It was time to go. I think just personally, you know, I was going through a divorce. I needed a fresh start. So I came back to New York City. I didn't have anything lined up. And so I spent 3 months kind of on my brother's couch. So thank you to him for that. And you know, I was on this job search and Albany was one of the places that had a great offer. I came in here, I was so excited. And I think for me, it was, I wanted more. And, you know, I love being out in the community. I love telling people stories. And as much as I love anchoring doesn't give you a lot of that time. You know, there's not that much of a, I guess, leisure into, hey, let's go out into the community. Let's tell these stories. And I think towards the end of my time, I just found that it just wasn't working, right? Like it was not what I wanted to do or how I wanted to tell news. And so it was very amicable when we left. You know, I kind of expressed my concerns to, you know, to management and we kind of parted ways that way. And so in the meantime, what I started to do was follow a passion project that, you know, I had kind of pitched it when I was still working in Louisiana many years ago. And the station there was phenomenal, but they're just like, we're not a podcast people, right? Like we don't do that. We're a news station. Kentucky, when I moved there, they had a podcast, but it was all true crime. And so that didn't work with what I wanted to do. I love true crime, but I think there's a different need for the public and the community right now. And so I left, you know? And so I said, if not now, then when? And so I kind of walked away from news and said, I'm taking a big leap of faith. I'm believing before I'm seeing, and I'm going to launch a podcast.
Where did this idea come from and what inspired you?
So 10 years ago, my dad committed suicide. And I knew that when he died, I wanted to make sure that his death did not go in vain. We were blindsided by his death. You know, I kind of threw myself into the literature of, you know, what is suicide, the depression, and what are the warning signs? What are things that we need to look for? And 2 years later, I picked up and I moved cross country to try to run away from my issues, right? And so I've kind of had this great backdrop of news where I didn't have to face it because I would tell other people's stories and other people's traumas. And I never had to face my own demons. And so the podcast came about when I started to talk to more and more people. And I was like, wow, everybody seems to have a story, you know, like may not be suicide, but everybody's got something that they're going through. And so many of these people in my time and travels had helped me along the way, you know, kind of in my ups and downs of mental health. Sorry, my God.
Saying okay.
Hello
to
she wanted a cameo. You know, in Louisiana, when I would cover events like hurricanes or child abuse or addiction and substance abuse and things of that nature, you know, there are so many stories and so many different things that I wanted to talk about. And so now where I'm at in the point of my life, I said, you know, it's time to tell people my story. And the way to do that, or at least the way to open the conversation about mental health is by telling my story and finally opening that platform up and saying, hey, let's have a discussion about mental health. Because if 2020 taught us anything, it's that nobody is immune from mental health. And, you know, whether it's on a low level or on a large level, you know, we saw high rates of suicide during 2020 and then going into 2021, we saw high rates of depression. We saw, you know, people with instability, right? Food instability, housing instability, all of that plays a role into how we function as humans and our mental health. And so the podcast is called And That's Okay. It's about these moments in our life that, you know, kind of life throws curveballs at you and you're not ready for them. And oftentimes we're not, right? And so it's not okay, right? But we're taking those moments in our life and figuring out how to make them okay.
Now, in addition to your father, which obviously was your biggest curveball, what other curveballs would you say that you've met that really have helped you grow, where you thought this might be a stop point, but it's not going to be, I'm not going to let it be, I'm going to overcome it and have this help me with my growth?
You know, I talk a lot. I get very personal on the podcast, and I talk to kind of different experiences that people have had. And so my divorce was another thing that really affected me. And I go into detail kind of what happened in my marriage and the things that I went through in there. And I think the moment that I started to talk about some of the abuse that I went through and some of the mental issues that kind of spiraled and you know, I guess, how do I want to say this? I think that like we're all mingled with even the job and the marriage aspect and being new to a city and kind of trying to navigate all these different things, right? Because you're navigating in news, we're in like a news station every 2 years, right? So there's always that mental struggle of, will I fit in? This is a new city, new friends, new people, new job. You know, so add that a new marriage, a very dysfunctional, toxic marriage, and then trying to navigate through the woes and ups and downs of just kind of news life, all of that combined, I think, you know, kind of propelled me onto this path of where I'm at today, where, you know, the death of my father was so horrific and it took me such a long time to be okay to even talk about it. And I talk about that, right? Like I talk about my journey with therapy. I talk about my journey with depression and his suicide, but I also now talk about very openly the abuse that I went through, right? In my marriage and then the divorce process and other people's stories that kind of helped me along the way to get better, to realizing that this is going to be okay. You know, like you're not okay right now, but you're going to be okay. It's going to take some time. And so that's what we're doing. I'm sharing in a lot of people's traumas, a lot of people's journeys, the same way that I would in news, on just a bigger level, on a longer scale, right? So podcasting gives me time to do it on an hour instead of a minute and 30 and telling those stories. So that's where we are.
Is there anybody's name you could share, somebody that people should watch out for to listen and see join you on the podcast?
Absolutely. So episode one that drops on September 9th will be kind of, it will be my story, but it will also, you'll kind of get to see a glimpse of all the different people that I've recorded so far. And I have a list of people that unfortunately just didn't happen before the launch date. So, and you know, you'll kind of see their story progress, but episode one, which will not be on the 9th, will be the following week, September 16th, will be Benita Zahn. And so she kicks us off with a great, you know, kind of conversation, and it's lighthearted. Benita is phenomenal. You know, when I walked into the news station, she was one of the first people I met, and we clicked right away. And I guess we only worked a handful of times together because our times were so different, but we've had lunch since then. We've had phone conversations, text messages, and she's become this just guide for me. And she too right now is going through so many life changes. And so, you know, that's kind of where we kick it off. We kick it off on a light note, but a great note nonetheless.
So, and that actually leads me to my final question before we let you go. You mentioned Benita Zahn, obviously both you and Benita left the industry, like I said, to kind of go on to your next step in your career. What do you think it is about local news? And this is not just television news. It's print that I work in, it's radio, it's news and media as a whole. What do you think is causing, from your opinion, at this point in time, this kind of the last couple of years, really having people leave and start careers outside of the business and outside of the industry?
So I want to say that I don't know that my news career is over altogether. Like I walked away from news now because I need to work on this passion project and this is what's calling me. I find every time I say, never will I ever, I always end up going to never have I ever. Like that always yeah. seems to be the path that I end up going on. So I can't say I'm out of news forever. I just know I'm out of news for now. And you know, most recently I've had so many friends who did leave news, and I think it's the pressure. I think it's, the times are changing. The audience is changing. People don't necessarily, you know, I guess, look to news the way that they used to before. the time crunch on the amount of time that we have to tell stories is there. And it's real, you know, it's fast paced. It's great. It's local, but you lose so much of the essence of what these stories need to have. And you can't do that in a minute and 30 or a minute and 10 seconds. Right. So, you know, deadlines, the way that newsrooms just operate, I think has changed in the last 6, 7, 8 years that I've been in it. And I think all of that together, coupled with just the times that we're in, you know, the fake news movement and, you know, Kentucky, I've lived through the social justice protests. And I think all of that kind of puts a lot of things into perspective for a lot of people. And they say, do I want to keep calling my family and saying, you know, I was okay, but I wasn't, you know, and like, it kind of, right. It stays with you. And so I think for so many of us, it's just saying there has to be a better way to tell people's stories, and local news may not be that outlet.
Well, right now, like I said, you're going to have the platform to tell these stories. So remind everybody the name of your podcast and where they'll be able to find it, and as well as your website, because I know you're launching a website as well.
Yes. Yeah. So the podcast is called And That's Okay. So you can find it on YouTube, and you can look and subscribe right away. We have a little introduction on there. So it's And That's Okay with Paulina Bucka on YouTube. The website is andthatsokay.net. So all the episodes will be on there. There'll be a little blog post on there, all of the things that we go through, like, you know, Kristi, your episode, and then kind of the podcast that I'm featured on as well will be on there. So all of that you can find there. Check my Facebook, my Instagram, and of course, Twitter, and you'll be able to connect one way or another. Just subscribe, follow. And I guess that's all I can tell you.
Thank you so much. And I should add too that Times Union readers, your 20 Things You Don't Know About Me is coming up. We'll have that shortly too, so people can learn even more about you, and we'll definitely be listening and tuning in. Thank you so much for sharing. Thank you for your honesty. I really appreciate it. I'm looking forward to seeing what's next for you.
Perfect. Thank you, Kristi.